If you've ever worn an animal print, or if you find yourself irresistibly drawn to bold patterns, you owe a nod to Roberto Cavalli. Picture the essence of the 2000s. Vibrant patterns, bold floral and animal prints, sequin, denim, and so on. Roberto Cavalli, a maestro of decadence, epitomized this era with his lavish lifestyle, characterized by endless summer, champagne fountains, and opulent extravagance. His brand exuded the same allure, captivating consumers with its portrayal of luxury and excess. Just 2 weeks ago, on the 12th of April, the world lost a true visionary of the fashion world. Roberto Cavalli, renowned for his groundbreaking designs and innovative approach, passed away at the age of 83. Celebrities like Victoria Beckham, Heidi Klum, Adriana Lima, and others paid tribute to him on Instagram. Cavalli transformed his eponymous label into a symbol of luxurious living. But what made him so iconic? What set him apart? And what iconic creations made him famous? Hey guys, my name is Anna, I hope you're doing well, and today we'll be diving deep into the world of Roberto Cavalli. Let's get started. Roberto Cavalli was born in 1940 in Florence, Italy. He inherited the artistic talent that ran in the family. His grandfather, Giuseppe Rossi, was an impressionist painter, and his mother was a seamstress. So it was no surprise that Cavalli ended up attending the Academy of Art in Florence in the late 1950s, concentrating in textile print. However, he found his artistic expression in applying paint to textiles in new inventive ways, thereby creating exciting new clothing designs. He said the following: "My dream, maybe because of my family, was to be a painter. I chose in one moment the direction of textiles. From textiles, I went to fashion." One of the factors that contributed to his fame was his innovative use of leather. He was among the first designers to popularize its use. Previously considered a thick material mainly confined to bags and shoes, leather underwent a transformation under his hands, becoming a staple material for fashionable dresses. Roberto nurtured his ideas over many years, finally showcasing his innovative designs in his debut collection in 1970. In addition to experimenting with leather, he developed a revolutionary printing technique specifically for this material. Using glove leather sourced from a prestigious French tannery, he mastered the art of crafting dyed leather evening gowns. These pioneering techniques made their debut in Paris, where their value was immediately recognized, leading Roberto to promptly patent them. Subsequently, he began receiving commissions from renowned design houses, including Hermès and Pierre Cardin. In addition to his pioneering work with leather, and prior to developing his iconic aesthetic, Roberto Cavalli was renowned for his hippie-inspired style. His early experience in textile design for furniture greatly influenced his approach to clothing. Moreover, Cavalli demonstrated remarkable foresight in marketing by identifying emerging fashion destinations. For instance, he opened his inaugural boutique in Saint-Tropez in 1972, recognizing its potential long before it gained widespread acclaim as a fashionable destination. In the 1980s, Japanese deconstructionism swept through the fashion world, presenting a stark contrast to Cavalli's signature style. His inherently bold aesthetic struggled to compete with the prevailing minimalist trend. However, by 1988, Cavalli reclaimed the spotlight with a resurgence in innovation and design. This time, he introduced a new fashion staple that would stand the test of time, and it was denim. It's fair to say that he revolutionized the denim industry, not only through innovative printing techniques, but also by pioneering the first sandblasted jeans collections. By infusing denim with luxury and creating new silhouettes, Cavalli revealed himself as a true fashion pioneer. His exploration of denim reached its pinnacle with a collaboration with Lycra, resulting in the introduction of stretch jeans in 1995, now considered a fashion essential. However, things really escalated for Roberto Cavalli with the turn of the new millennium. In addition to his main line, which is distributed in over 50 countries worldwide, Roberto Cavalli expanded into menswear and accessories, including perfumes, underwear, and beachwear. Beginning in the year 2000, with a focus on the youth market, Just Cavalli made the characteristic style more available for younger audiences. And we cannot discuss Cavalli without talking about animal print. It became another characteristic hallmark of his designs. According to Cavalli, zebra print is a neutral pattern, and this quote offers us an insight into his design philosophy. His affection for animals was obvious throughout his entire life. He kept many pets, including German shepherds, exotic birds, and Persian cats. Snakes are also featured prominently in his designs, believed by Cavalli to be a symbol of luck. One of his most famous creations, the iconic snake leather pants, contributed significantly to his fame. In addition to his fashion ventures, displaying his full entrepreneurial spirit, Cavalli inaugurated his first cafe store in Florence in the year 2002, adorning it with his iconic animal print motifs. This was soon followed by the launch of the Just Cavalli Cafe at Torre Branca in Milan, alongside another boutique in Villa della Spiga. Not stopping there, nightclubs and event venues across Italy bear the Just Cavalli name. These spaces are also embellished with a distinctive Cavalli print turned decor. This fusion of fashion, gastronomy, and design has become synonymous with the Roberto Cavalli brand. Through these establishments, Cavalli forged a connection between locations and his clothing, intertwining lifestyle and fashion. In December of 2004, a Cavalli exhibition took place in the Met in New York. It was titled Wild: Fashion Untamed. This exhibition delved into the human fascination with animal skins and animal references in clothing throughout history. In 2007, Cavalli was commissioned by some of the music industry's leading singers, including Christina Aguilera, J-Lo, and the Spice Girls, to design costumes for their concerts. But we'll talk about that later. In 2010, his passion for designing for women, coupled with the admiration for his designs, culminated in Cavalli's fashion label being listed as the number one women's fashion brand in the luxury brand status index. However, after 2016, Roberto Cavalli stepped aside from designing for his fashion house, which nearly faced bankruptcy. There's a notion in the fashion world that when a designer reaches a certain age, their ability to create something revolutionary diminishes. According to some, Cavalli's designs seem to be out of touch with the aesthetics of the 2010s, appearing to be stuck in the early 2000s. Nonetheless, thanks to investors, the brand avoided closure. In the 2020s, it feels weird to say 2020s, like the 20s in the current context. Other brands like Bloomerine, Juicy Couture, and Von Dutch experienced a resurgence in popularity largely due to the revival of the Y2K trends. The new creative director of the brand, Fausto Puglisi, is deeply immersed in a bright, print-filled aesthetic, which he both preserves and enhances with innovative touches. While he acknowledges a fondness for the 70s attitude, he emphasizes that he isn't nostalgic. His vision for Cavalli not only pays homage to his storied past, but also propels it boldly into the future, positioning it as a coveted brand for the Gen Z audience. Roberto Cavalli is a brand that I resonate deeply with. It has always symbolized women's liberation and seduction. Besides Roberto Cavalli's manipulation of different materials, one of the factors that made him famous was his interpretation of female empowerment. Many attribute his success not only to his innovative ideas, but also to his deep understanding of women's desires, transforming the image of female beauty. Embracing a hypersexual feminine force, the women in his designs exude confidence, unafraid to embrace their sexuality and power. For Cavalli, it's not about pleasing men, but about empowering women and showcasing their strengths through sexuality. Cavalli's admiration for women is particularly notable, and it's especially evident in his iconic designs for red carpets, particularly during the late 1990s and the early 2000s. Cavalli became the go-to brand for many celebrities, catapulting him to incredible fame. He encapsulated the desires of fashionistas of that era, characterized by a craving for bright colors, lavish luxury, and bold, shiny fashion. His first female celebrity ambassador, Brigitte Bardot, played a crucial role in putting him on the international fashion map. She was followed by a succession of powerful and very sexy women, including Kate Moss, Gisele Bündchen, Spice Girl, Sharon Stone, and Jennifer Lopez. Celebrities sought out his designs for their vibrant allure. And Roberto Cavalli once mentioned that he didn't understand the concept of unisex fashion, instead embracing the mystery and allure of femininity. Self-proclaimed feminist Cavalli is unapologetic about drawing inspiration and admiration from women, asserting the following: "Maybe I'm the only man to say this, but women are stronger than men, and they have more personality. His muse has always been the glamorous, sophisticated woman exuding confidence with a free-spirited, bohemian element." In the late 1990s and the early 2000s, Cavalli's popularity soared as his vibrant designs gained traction on the streets. The designer said the following in the year 2001: After 25 years, Roberto Cavalli has finally been discovered. And it is kind of true because although his career began in 1970, Cavalli spent nearly two decades in relative obscurity before emerging as the red carpet star in the 1990s. His designs became ubiquitous on celebrities, further fueling the popularity. Today, celebrities continue to wear archival Cavalli designs on red carpets, reflecting a resurgence of interest in the bold styles of the 2000s. From revolutionizing leather and denim to reimagining nature, Cavalli epitomized boldness in fashion. As he once said, "Fashion that is not crazy is not fashion." To sum up, Roberto Cavalli's indelible mark on the fashion industry resonates through his innovative designs, bold aesthetic, and unwavering dedication to celebrating the beauty and strength of women. From revolutionizing the use of materials like leather and denim to redefining the concept of female empowerment, Cavalli's legacy transcends mere fashion trends. Through his visionary and luxurious creations, he not only captured the spirit of his time, but also carved out a unique space in the history of fashion. Cavalli's influence continues to inspire designers and fashion enthusiasts alike, ensuring his enduring legacy as a true icon of style and creativity. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Your support means the world to me. Thank you so much. Stay tuned for the next video, and until then, take care and bye-bye.